Gopi Jana Vallabha Jagiri Varadha Gopi Jana Yashoda Nandana Braja Jalaranjana Yashoda Nandana Braja Jalaranjana Jamuna Tira Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna. Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Gopinath Radha, Gopinath Radhe Radhe. Itay Gaur Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Gaur Hari Bol. Jayo Jay Prabhupada, 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 Jayo Prabhupada. जय ओम विष्णुपाद परमहंस परिव्रजकाचार्य अष्टोत्तर शतशिशुवरिष्ठ देवांग्रेस एसी भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी श्रील प्रभुपाद की जय। जय ओम विष्णुपाद परमहंस परिव्रजकाचार्य अष्टोत्तर शतशिशुवरिष्ठ देवांग्रेस भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी महाराज श्रील प्रभुपाद की जय। अनंत कोटि वैष्णववृंद की जय। नामाचार्य श्रील हरिदास ठाकुर की जय। प्रेम से कहो श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासति गौर भक्तवृंद श्री श्री राधा कृष्णा गोप गोपीनाथ श्याम कुंड राधा कुंड गिरी गोवर्धन की जय। ब्रजभूमि श्री वृंदावन धाम की जय। नवद्वीप मायापुर धाम की जय। पुरुषोत्तम क्षेत्र श्री जगन्नाथपुरी धाम की जय। गंगा मैया जमुना मैया की जय। भक्ति देव श्री तुलसी महारानी की जय। नितय गौर प्रेमानंदे हरि हरि गौर प्रेम हरि हरि ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ओम नमो भगवते नारायणं नमस्कृत्यं नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरये। नष्टप्रायेषु अभद्रेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया भगवतीरुत्तम श्लोके भक्तिर्भवतीं नैष्टिके। कृष्णाय वासुदेवाय देवकी नंदनाय च नंदगोपकुमाराय गोविंदाय नमो नमः। तप्त कांचन गौरांगे राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवि प्रणमामि हरि प्रिय। वांछा कल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिंधु भेव च पतितानां पावने वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासन कौरवकवृ हरे कृष्ण हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे राम राम हरे हरे ओम ज्ञानति मृन्दस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाकय चक्षुर्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः नमो ओं विष्णुपादाय कृष्णपृष्ठाय भूतले ಶ್ರೀಮತೇ ಭಕ್ತಿವೇದಾಂತ ಸ್ವಾಮಿ ನಾಮನೆ ನಮಸ್ತೆ ಸಾರಸ್ವತಿ ದೇವಿ ಗೌರವಾಣಿ ಪ್ರಚಾರಿಣಿ ನಿರ್ವಿಶೇಷ ಶೂನ್ಯವಾದಿ ಪಾಶ್ಚಾತ್ಯ ದೇಶದಾಯಿ ಹರೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಸೊ ಐ ವೆಲ್ಕಮ್ ಆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಯು ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟು ದಿಸ್ ಸಂಡೇ ಫೀಸ್ಟ್ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ರಿಯಲಿ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ಫುಲ್ ಟು ಶ್ರೀ ರಾಧೇಶ್ಯಾಮ್ ಪ್ರಭುಜಿ ಫಾರ್ ಬ್ಲೆಸ್ಸಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಮೀ ಸೊ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ವೀಕ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ 18 ಟು 24th ವಿ ಆರ್ ಸೆಲೆಬ್ರೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಇಸ್ಕಾನ್ ಆಲ್ ಓವರ್ ದ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಸೆಲೆಬ್ರೇಟಿಂಗ್ Holy Name Week, World Holy Name Holy Week. So, I have been told to speak on the glories of Hare Krishna Mahamantra or Harinam Sankirtan. So, today's our subject is glorification of Hare Krishna Mahamantra. Once Srila Prabhupada, he was giving a class and suddenly one person raised his hand and he said, Swamiji, I can see that all you people, ISKCON people, they always chant Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. So my question is, does this Hare Krishna mantra, this sound vibration, enter in your heart? Because I think it is all imaginary. It's all blind faith. It is not scientific. Because when you chant Hare Krishna mantra, what effect it will have? So he was speaking it in a derogatory way. So he was trying to offend Hare Krishna Mantra and also the Prabhupada's position. So then Prabhupada said, now my question to you is, when I call you a rascal, when I call you a stupid or a rascal, does that word enter in your heart? Does it go inside your heart? So he kept it very quietly. He said, yes Swamiji, that word went inside my heart. So then Prabhupada said, this simple one word, rascal, you know, this is an ordinary word, shabda. But it entered in your heart and you will remember this word rascal, that I called you rascal, you will remember this throughout your day. Not only throughout your day, throughout your life you will remember this, that you are sitting in this hall and this Swamiji called me a rascal. Can you imagine just one word rascal? It remains in your heart throughout your life. What to speak of Hare Krishna mantra, which is spiritually completely transcendental. When we chant Krishna's holy name, how much Krishna will remember us? So this is not an ordinary shabda, or it is not an ordinary word, rascal or something like that. And then Prabhupada said, if you chant water, 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 even if you go on chanting for millions of years, your thirst will not be quenched. Because it's a material sound. water, water, water. But Krishna's sound, Nama Jintamani Krishna, Chaitanya Rasa Vigraha, Purna Shuddho Nitya Mukto, Abhinatvam Nama Namino. Krishna and His holy name, there is no difference. And especially in this Kali Yuga, the recommended process is simply hearing and chanting. Shrinvata Swakatha Krishna Punya Shravana Kirtanam Hridayantastohi Abhadrani Hridanoti Srihasatam. Simply by chanting Hare Krishna mantra and hearing that sound vibrations, all our anarthas will be vanquished. And therefore, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who is a Sankirtanaika Pitaro, who is the father of the Sankirtan movement, he started this Hare Krishna mantra Sankirtan. So every day Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in Navadvip Mayapur, early in the morning, when the sun would rise in the eastern horizon, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu would take all his devotees and go for Harinam Sankirtan. Udillo Aruna Puravabhage Dvijamani Gauramane Jage Udilo Aruna Puravabhage Dvijamani Gauramane Jage Bhakat Samuha Loiya Saathe Gela Nagar Gaje Bhakat Samuha Loiya Saathe Gela Nagar Gaje Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he would take all his devotees and he would chant his Hare Krishna mantra. So Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Krishna himself. If he wanted, he could have given so many other processes. But because in Kali Yuga, Kritiya Dhyayato Vishnu, Tretayam Jato Makher, Dwapare Paricharyaya, Kalotad Hari Kirtana. In Kali Yuga, in Satya Yuga, people would meditate for hundreds and thousands of years. In Treta Yuga, the Yuga Dharma was performing Yajna. In Dwapar Yuga, elaborate deity worship. But in Kali Yuga, we people all, you know, Prayana Alpayushah Sabhya Kalo Asmin Yuga Janaha Manda Sumanda Matayor Manda Bhagyahi Upadritaha. Sometimes we say, you know, God is very cruel. He is so cruel that he is not even paying attention to all our jivas. Krishna is so merciful. Krishna knows in this material world, especially in this Kali Yuga, we are not qualified to do any other things. Krishna says, my dear sir, O Kali Yuga jiva, you cannot perform yajna? No problem. You are not qualified? No problem. You have no money? No problem. Just chant my Hare Krishna mantra, my holy name. And even whether you are a male or a female, whatever gender, whatever, you know, caste, creed you belong to, whatever nation you belong to, whether you are a young, old, or a crippled bodied, whoever you are, simply chant Hare Krishna mantra and you will get the benefit of all those three yugas. Our acharyas give you example.
Suppose like if we have a wound on our body, so what do? We apply some ointment or some turmeric on it. But if a patient has wounds all over his body, then what happens? That patient is put into the vessel of ointment or turmeric. Because now there is no point in applying just one or two drops here and there. So in Kali Yuga, therefore Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he is so merciful. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu knew that in this Kali Yuga, all these processes, performing yajna or tapasya, dhyan, they have no potency or very less potency, very little potency. So therefore,
Udilo Aruna Purababhage Dvichamani Gora Manjage. Bhakat Samuha Loya Sathe Gela Nagar Braje.
To perform yajna, you need so much of money, resources, energy, people. But in Kali Yuga, Srimad Bhagavatam explains in 6th canto, Ajamil's case, Srimad Bhagavatam explains that Sankhetam parihasyam va stovam helanam eva va vaikuntanam grahanam asheshagaharam vidhu. Even if you chant this Hare Krishna mantra, Sankhityam. Sankhityam means simply by indicating. You don't even mean that you are chanting Krishna's name. You are calling Krishna, you are calling Rama, you are calling Sri Radha. No, only Sankhityam. Sankhityam means indicating. Just like in our Vedic culture, we give our children's name, Ram, Krishna, Govinda. So when we call our child, hey Krishna, come here. Hey Govinda, come here. Hey Ram, go there, right? So simply by calling our child's name, Krishna takes it very seriously that this person is calling me. So simply by indicating Krishna's holy name, we get the benefit. But that is not true in the Satya Yuga or Treta Yuga. In Kali Yuga, if you perform any pious activity within your mind, on a mental level, still get the benefit. But in Satya Yuga, if you commit any pious activity in the mind, you won't get any benefit. But if you commit any sinful activity, even within the mind, you get the reaction. See, Kali Yuga is so merciful. But we people are so unfortunate. Previously, we would keep Krishna, Govinda, Ram name. Now we give name to our children, Tinnu. Munni, Tinnu. We are so unfortunate. Sometimes we give names, very ghastly names. It's like just by remembering, just by saying the name of the child, we remember some kind of ghostly beings. Right? Sometimes people, nowadays the youngsters, they have that phobia of making tattoos. Sometimes they make a tattoo of dragons. Sometimes scorpions. Right? Scorpions and dragons. See, when you are looking at your own arms and seeing those tattoos, you should remember Krishna, right? Previously also people would make tattoos on their hands. There was Hanuman, Ram, Govinda, Krishna. So, Sankhityam means simply by indicating, you get the benefit. Just like people have this He-Man, Spider-Man. So instead of making that He-Man or seeing the Spider-Man, you can remember Hanuman or Hanuman. So Sankhyatya means simply by remembering Hanuman, you will get the benefit. So, there you go. Bhaj Gaurango, kaho Gaurango, loho Gaurangir naam re. Bhaj Gaurango, kaho Gaurango, loho Gaurangir naam re. Means simply by indicating Krishna's name, we'll get the same benefit. Second is Parihasyam Va. Parihasyam Va means chanting Krishna's holy name jokingly. Sometimes you don't even mean, you know, what is Krishna. Very famous example people always give, you know, when Radha Shampu would work in Mathuran flat in Pune. So Sudham Prabhu joked at him, Radha Shampu, because Radha Shampu would put on Tila Kantimala and he would go to companies. So Sudham Prabhu jokingly he said, what did he say, Prabhuji? Jai Radhe, what is it? Jai Sri Ram. Sudham Prabhu said, Jai Sri Ram. So Radha Shampu took it very seriously. So then after some time, Sudham Prabhu saw that Radha Shampu, Sudham Prabhu also sitting next to Radha Shampu, seven-headed saffron cloth. So even if someone chants jokingly, like Jagai and Madhai, when Nityananda Prabhu, Haridas Thakur and others, they would perform Sankirtan on the street of Navadip. Once Jagai and Madai, they were fully intoxicated, liquored. So then they saw, wow, this Nityananda's Kirtan is very nice. Huh? This Hare Krishna, Hare Ram, this is very nice. So just by appreciating that Hare Krishna mantra, they became qualified to receive, they become the recipient of Krishna's holy name. Therefore, bhakti sanjayate bhakti. We cannot come into Krishna consciousness by simply performing any ordinary pious activities. We have to have some connection with spiritual, like bhakti process. Either you come across with some holy name, prasad, or devotees' lectures. These are the means to accept Krishna consciousness. So Jagai and Madai, they became fully qualified to accept the mercy of Nityananda Prabhu. And jokingly they said, this Hare Krishna, Hare Ram is very nice. After some time they were delivered by Nityananda Prabhu and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. It is very famous. Dam maro dam. Pura gana nahi gaunga main. Bolo subha sham, Hare Krishna, Hare Ram. So that movie became very famous, Devananda's movie. So devotees came to Prabhupada and said, Prabhupada, see this movie. People always say, dam maro dam, dam maro dam. And then Prabhupada said, don't worry. They will, after some time, they will forget the dam maro dam and they will remember only Hare Krishna, Hare Ram. Of course, for that time being, people had to go really some kind of a torture. But then what Prabhupada said, it became true. After some time, when Prabhupada started Radha Ras Bihari temple in Juhu, it was in a remote village area. Nobody would go to that place in 1970s, 72, 73, 74. And when after this movie, after 75, Hare Krishna, Hare Ram movie, people, they had that query, you know, that inquiry that, oh, where are these people? Foreign people are chanting. Everyone is miserable, you know. They want to forget their gum. Dam varadam midjaya gum. So they wanted to forget their gum. They were coming to this Juhu temple searching. Where are those foreigners? After some time, that temple becomes so famous. Now it is one of the tourist places in our Mumbai Darshan. So even jokingly, if someone chants Krishna's holy name, he becomes recipient of Krishna's mercy. Sometimes we'll find when we perform Sankirtan, there are many dogs, you will find them wagging their tails. That means they are appreciating Krishna's holy name. Previously, they had some connection with Krishna's holy name. So in this lifetime, when they came across the holy name, Hare Krishna mantra, wow, in my previous life, I had chanted this mantra, but I could not finish my journey. So in this lifetime, no problem. Baj gaurango, kaho gaurango, laho gaurangir namare.
Jana gaurango baje se hai mor prana re. Tathai tatai bhaje lako ghana ghana tahe jhanjar lo. Tathai tatai bhaje lako ghana ghana tahe jhanjar lo.
Sankhetyam parihasyam va stobham va. Stobham va means with musical instruments. When Srila Prabhupada, first time he went to Tompkins Square Park, so Prabhupada had one small dubdugi. He was chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. And they were all hippies, fully drunk. But they appreciated Prabhupada's Swami singing Hare Krishna mantra. So they also had their own instruments. Somebody brought the guitar and sitar and so many instruments. And if you see that video, throughout that Tompkins Square Park, everyone fully intoxicated, but they are playing their own instrument. So even if someone, so they were singing their own songs, but they were singing, playing their own instruments, but Hare Krishna mantra was the common thing. Everyone was either chanting or hearing Krishna's holy name. And the last one is Helanamva. Helanamva means consciously criticizing the holy name. Just like in our families, sometimes the husband is not a devotee, sometimes wife is not a devotee, sometimes children are not devotee, sometimes friends are not devotee. If your friends are not favorable to your Krishna consciousness, they are consciously criticizing Hare Krishna mantra, you can change your friend circle. Anyway, we have been changing our friend circle since so many times. In our childhood, when we were studying in KG and other things, our childhood circle, friend circle was different. When we were studying in 7th, 8th standard, 10th standard, our friend circle was different. During our college time, our friend circle was different. After marriage, no friend circle at all. Right? So there is no harm giving up a friend circle, but please don't change your family members. There is no need to change a husband or a wife or a children because they are consciously criticizing Harinam. Sometimes people say, oh, my wife, she is not a devotee, she is not favorable, so she is criticizing Hare Krishna mantra, therefore I don't want to stay with her. No, sir. There is no recommendation that you change your wife or husband or children. You have to stay with them. Use your intelligence, how you can manage and still chant Hare Krishna. Baj Gaurango, kaho Gaurango, laho Gaurangir naam re. Je jana Gaurango, baj se haan mor praan. मुकुंद माधव यादव हरे बोलन बोल रे वदन हो रे मुकुंद माधव यादव हरे बोलन बोल रे वदन हो मिच निदाव से गेलो रे राते दिवस शरीर साजे मिच निदाव से गेलो रे राते दिवस शरीर साजे जागो जीव जागो गोरा चांद बोले जीव जागो जीव जागो गोरा चांद बोले कोथा निद्रा जाओ माया पिशाचिर खोले कोथा निद्रा जाओ माया पिशाचिर खोले Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, along with his devotees, he would chant Hare Krishna mantra and also he would say, Jiva Jago, Jiva Jago. So now we should remember that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he would perform Sankirtan early in the morning. Now even if he says Jiva Jago, Jiva Jago, that Jago doesn't mean 11 o'clock or 12 o'clock. Sometimes our morning starts at 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock. He said, yes, yes, Mahaprabhu Chaitanya told us, Jiva Jago, Jiva Jago, now I'll wake up. At 10 o'clock or 11 o'clock. Shastra says that every activity has its particular time. Dharma, artha, kama, moksha. Dharma means religious activities. All the religious activities should be performed, dharma should be performed in the early hours of morning period. Brahma Muhurta starts at 4 o'clock. If it is too early for you every day, no problem. Brahma Muhurta extends till 7 o'clock. That, you know, extra energy is there till 7 o'clock. At least before 7 o'clock, 6 o'clock, we should wake up and chant Hare Krishna mantra. Because dharma means all chanting and everything, this should be performed in the Brahma Muhurta. Artha should be performed, artha should be earned during the daytime and calm in the night. So in this way, when we respect the timings by performing all these activities in their particular time, we get the moksha. Therefore, jiva jago means, my dear soul, now at least you have got a human body, human form of life, start chanting Hare Krishna mantra. Jivara kalyana sadhana ka jagate asiya madhurana जीवर कल्याण साधन का जगते आसिया मधुर ना
अविद्या ती मेरा तपन रूपे हृदय गगन विराजे अविद्या ती मेरा तपन रूपे हृदय गगन विराजे
Jivera Kalyana Sadhana Kam. Therefore, for the deliverance of all the conditioned soul, Sri Krishna Himself, He appeared in His holy name. At the end of the Afar Yuga, Krishna disappeared from this world. But again, actually, He didn't go to heaven, He didn't go to the Golok Vrindavan. Immediately, He took a U-turn. After crossing that Swarga planet, heavenly planet, immediately He took a U-turn. And He again come on this earth planet in the form of His holy name. Once Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, after taking bath in the ocean, He came to Siddha Bakul to meet Haridas Thakur. And He inquired from Haridas Thakur, My dear Haridas, I can see no hope for these Kali Yuga creatures. They are so sinful. What is the means of their deliverance? And then Haridas Thakur said, very humbly, He said, My dear Mahaprabhu, You are like a spiritual sun and I am like an insignificant spark. Who am I to speak in front of you? But because I am your puppet, I am your servant, and because you are ordering me, therefore I am speaking now. Then Haridas Thakur said, Eka Krishna Nama Kore Sarva Papakshay Nava Vidya Bhakti Purna Nama Hoite Hai He said, even if someone chants once Hare Krishna Mantra, Eka Krishna Nama Kore Sarva Papakshay, all the millions of lifetime sinful reactions will be burnt simply by chanting once Hare Krishna Mantra. Now please don't take disadvantage of this. Because sometimes you say, wow, just by chanting once Hare Krishna Mantra, okay, no problem. I'll perform all types of sinful activities and yes, before death, 100% pakka, once at least I'll chant Hare Krishna Mantra. Of course, we cannot fool Krishna, we cannot cheat Krishna. So, Haridas Thakur says, Eka Krishna Nama Kare Sarva Papakshay Nava Vidya Bhakti Purna Nama Hoite Hoy All this Nava Vidya process, nine process of devotional service are included simply in hearing and chanting. In Kali Yuga, actually there are two ways. One is a Pancharatrika Vidhi and other is a Bhagavat Vidhi. But Pancharatrika Vidhi and all other processes, they are incomplete if you don't take shelter of Bhagavat Vidhi. Bhagavat Vidhi is completely independent. If someone is only chanting Hare Krishna Mantra and doing nothing else, No deity worship, of course we are not against deity worship. Deity worship or any other processes, even some cultural programs, these, that, they are all supportive to Bhagavat Vidhi. If you are chanting Hare Krishna Mantra, along with chanting Hare Krishna Mantra, you are also performing some deity worship and then you are also doing some other work, that is very good. It will give boost, it will support your chanting Hare Krishna Mantra. But Prabhupada said, if someone is not chanting 16 rounds every day, then the same deity worship will appear like a burden, like a galagraha. If you are not chanting Hare Krishna Mantra 16 rounds every day, all our activities, after some time it will be bored. Person becomes prostrated. There is no taste. If you don't chant regularly 16 rounds, then there is no We won't find any interest in performing some seva or activity. And slowly, slowly, we'll start finding faults in the people. Also, we'll start finding faults in the process. So therefore, Haridas Thakur says to Mahaprabhu Chaitanya that simply by chanting Hare Krishna Mantra once, one becomes free from all the sinful reactions. And the examples are given. Valmiki Muni. Valmiki Rishi was a hunter. And he was such a person, he would kill or murder, he would murder a person or kill one animal, and after killing one personality, he would put one stone into one earthen pot. In this way, he had completed, filled 7 pots. And then Narad Muni appeared. And Narad Muni said, "My dear Valya," his name was Valya, "what are you doing?" He will get the sinful reaction of that. Then Narad Muni started preaching to him. And finally he said, "Now you just chant Ram, Ram, Krishna, Ram, not Krishna, Ram." So Valya started chanting Ram, Ram, Ram. After some time he became so purified, he compiled Ramayana. In not just becoming free from all the sinful reactions, he compiled Ramayana. Now please understand this very important point. All other processes like performing yajna, tapasya, or pancharatrika vidhi, or other processes, they can make us free from all the sinful reactions. But all other processes, they cannot purify our propensity to commit sinful activities. Only this Hare Krishna mantra has a potency and a power. It goes at the root of that propensity of committing sinful activities, and it uproots from there. Because, see, yajna and all other things, they can make you free from all the sinful reactions. But Hare Krishna mantra, because it's non-different from Krishna, it directly touches the heart like this. It enters inside the heart and touches the heart. Not only just purifies the heart, person develops Krishna prema. That Krishna prema is developed within the heart only by chanting Hare Krishna mantra. There is no other process. Other processes are meant only for religiosity. But chanting Hare Krishna mantra, it is like all in all. It also offers you Krishna prema. So Valmiki Rishi, by chanting Lord Rama's name, he became Valmiki, from Valya to Valmiki. Another example of Mrigari. Mrigari was a hunter. But by chanting Krishna's holy name, he became a great saintly person. Our acharyas also give example. Monkeys in Lord Ramachandra's Leela, Ramayan, you will find all the monkeys, they were not great engineers. Here we have metro lines in Mumbai, right? We are trying to make a flyover, bridges, under metro, this, that. And since so many years has been going on, but still we are not able to complete it. So just to make one bridge, it takes decades for engineers. And here, all are monkeys. Of course, Nala and Neela, they were from the heavenly planet. They were the special demigods. But most of the monkeys, there are many monkeys, they were just normal monkeys also. All these monkeys, they build a bridge not on the sand or earth. They build a bridge on the water. And by simply writing the Lord Rama's name and chanting Lord Rama's name. So chanting Hare Krishna mantra is so powerful. And final example is Draupadi Maya. Amazing. This is such a great lesson for all of us. Draupadi Mai, she showed that in this age, in this world, whoever you are, how much powerful, how much wealth we have, fame, prestige, your power, it won't help you. Simply by chanting Govinda, Hare Krishna, Draupadi Mai was saved from all. It's like a Baj Gaurango, Kaho Gaurango, Loho Gaurangir Naavare. Jai Jana Gaurango Baje Sehaar Mor Praarare. Krishna naam sudha kariya paar, judao bhakti vinod praar. Krishna naam sudha kariya paar,
जुड़ाओ भक्ति विनोद नाम बिना किचु नहीं को चौदा भुवन माजे
बोलो
नाम बिना छोदा भुवन माजे हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे 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 राम हरे राम 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 हरे
personality Narada Muni once approached Hanumanji and just to glorify him Narada Muni he spoke to Hanumanji he said my dear Hanuman you are not a devotee Hanumanji said my dear Narada Muni what happened to you why are you saying this he said no you are not even an ordinary person you are a very sinful personality he said how come you say that I am a sinful person then Narada Muni says You are one of the six aggressors. Because one of the six aggressors is the person who burns others' houses. And you not just burnt one house, you burnt the entire Lanka, all the houses. So how can you be a devotee? So Hanumanji said, My dear Narada Muniji, please listen. Why did I burn all those houses in Lanka? Because being a Lord Rama's devotee, this is my responsibility to claim, like to, you know, take care of all the unclaimed dead bodies. In Lanka, when I was burning all the houses, I saw all of them were dead. Narada Muni said, all of them were dead? No, they were burned by your fire. He said, no, my dear Narada Muni. The bodies which don't chant Lord Rama's name, they're as good as dead. Once there was a procession, and in the procession, all the people were mourning. They were all calling, Ram Naam Satya Hai, Ram Naam Satya Hai, Ram Naam Satya Hai. Everyone was chanting this Ram Naam Satya Hai. But one person who was lying down on a stretcher, and four people were carrying him on a shoulder, he was not chanting anything. So the small baby child, he asked his father, My dear father, I can see everyone in this procession, they are chanting Ram Naam Satya Hai. But this one person who is lying on the stretcher, he is not chanting Ram Naam Satya Hai. Why is it like that? His father said, Beta, it's very clear. He is dead. And dead bodies don't chant Ram Naam Satya Hai. Then child said, My dear father, can I draw a conclusion? Those who don't chant, they are dead. Because dead bodies don't chant. So therefore, those who are not chanting, they are dead bodies. Father said, yes, beta. So, Hanumanji said, those people who don't chant Hare Krishna Mantra, they are all as good as like dead. So therefore, I thought, they are dead. Let me perform the final rites. Let's read Srimad Bhagavatam. If you cannot read for 10 hours, 15 hours, 2 hours, 3 hours, at least for half an hour. Husband, wife and children should sit together and read Srimad Bhagavatam, chant 16 rounds and in the evening, short kirtan, 10-15 minutes kirtan. Kali Yuga and the Maya, jointly, they have no power to shake your faith from the holy name, and you will never be affected by Kali's effect and Maya's effect. In any house, a person, a whole family chants 16 rounds, reads Srimad Bhagavatam, and in the evening, little kirtan. So therefore, Mahaprabhu said, Bhaja Gaurango, Kaho Gaurango, Laho Gaurangir Navadeva.
Jaitana Gaurango, Bhaja Sihar Murpanare.
Shukadeva Goswami says, Kaler doshe nidhe rajan asti eko mahanguna kirtanadeva krishnasya mukta sangha param rajet. In this age of Kali is full with faults. Everything is nonsense in Kali Yuga. But one thing, what is that? Hare Nama. This whole Kali Yuga is quarrel and hypocrisy. But Hare Krishna Mantra is only one reality in our life. Everything is illusion. Everything is temporary. My dear sir, including our bodies. If our bodies, the body itself is temporary, how can our problems be permanent? Do you understand the logic? If our body itself, our body itself is temporary, how can our problems be permanent? So therefore, we should not take our problems so seriously. In Kali Yuga, the nature of the Kali Yuga is, even if you have small problems in life, mind hypes up, makes it bigger, and present like a monster in front of us. Therefore, Shukadeva Goswami says, my dear sir, or even Krishna, in Bhagavad Gita he says, Yavanartha udappane sarvataha sampluto dake. Previously in Vedic culture, in small villages, there were different types of well for different purposes. There was a drinking well, drinking water well. There was a well which was meant for washing vessels or washing clothes. So there were different wells for different purposes. But if there is a huge river, that river can fulfill all the purposes. Similarly, yajna, tapa, dana, charity, tapasya, going to Himalayas, performing karma kanda, and all these processes are included in chanting Hare Krishna mantra. If you are chanting Hare Krishna mantra, your vastu dosh is complete. Sometimes you say, oh, my house is not perfectly vastu. Are no problem, my dear sir. Hai bhi tumhara kitna din tak rahega tum wo ghar mein bhi. Body rehne wala hai to ghar kitna din rehne wala hai. Why do you take this problem so seriously? Of course, as long as we are in this body, we must take care of this body and the house, everything. But we should not be so much worried that we cannot even chant properly. We are not able to take care of your family members. So Shastra says, Yavanartha udapane sarvata sampludoke, means all your vastu problem, your nakshatra problem, your graha problem, your shani sare sati problem, and then what else? Rahu, Ketu. Seriously, it is not exaggeration, it's a fact. Hare Krishna mantra includes everything, because Hare Krishna mantra means, Krishna means naam. Namino, Abhinnatvam Namanamino, Krishna and His holy name, they are same personality. So Krishna says the entire universe rests on my body. So all this Rahu, Nakshatra, Ketra, they all included in my body. That means if you are chanting my holy name, everything is taken care. Even the best atonement, best tapasya, best yajna, everything is. And why worry? everything is going to perish every day. Bhaj Gaurango, kaho Gaurango, laho Gaurangir naam re. Jai Jana Gaurango, bhaj Sriha. नाम सुध करिय प्राण, कृष्ण नाम सुध करिय प्राण, जुड़ाओ भक्ति विनोद प्राण, नाम बिना किछु नाही को चौदह भुवन माजे बोलो हे राम बिना किछु नाही को चौदह भुवन माजे हरे कृष्णा हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्णा षोडशकं नामं कलिकल्मष नाशनम् नातो परतो उपाय सर्ववेदेषु दृश्यते इति षोडशकं दिस 16th सिलेबल हरे कृष्ण मंत्र इति षोडशकं नामं कलिकल्मष नाशनम् इट विल डिस्ट्रॉय ऑल द इफेक्ट्स ऑफ कलियुगा एंड नातः परतो उपाय. And my dear sir, if you don't chant Hare Krishna mantra, there is no other way. There is no other process other than chanting Hare Krishna mantra. Sarva Vedeshu Drishyate. And this is the conclusion of all the Vedic Shastras. Just like when sun rises in the eastern horizon, sun is not even completely risen. Simply by that reddish hue of a sun, all the darkness of the earth planet dissipates simply by the reddish hue. Similarly, even if a person doesn't even chant pure holy name, even at the stage of nama bhas, person starts relishing that holy name. Otherwise, you tell me, if someone is able to chant Hare Krishna mantra every day 16 rounds for years and years and years, for 2 decades, 3 decades, that shows that Krishna is reciprocating with that person. That person is tasting something. He is relishing that Harinam. Therefore, that person is able to chant for so many years. Otherwise, even if you pay someone, okay, my dear sir, I'll pay 1,000 rupees a month to you or 5,000 rupees a month to you, you just chant. And if that person has no attachment, attraction, or any loving feelings towards the holy name, that person won't be able to chant. So we may not understand it. It for us like a casual, today I completed my 16 rounds. My dear sir, it was the mercy of Krishna. It was the mercy of all the Vaishnavas that Krishna is so merciful. He has given some taste for chanting Hare Krishna mantra, and therefore we are able to chant Hare Krishna mantra. Parama Karuna Pahu Duija Nithai Gora Chandra Parama Karuna Pahu Duija Nithai Gora Chandra Sarasi Ramani Kevala Ananda Simply by the mercy of these beautiful two personalities, Nitya and Gauranga, no one is qualified in this age of Kali to chant Hare Krishna mantra or perform any active spiritual activity. But these two great, not great, they are the God, Krishna himself. Gaur and Nitai, by their mercy, we can chant Hare Krishna mantra. Let us be a little practical. Sometimes people ask, you know, even devotees also ask, Prabhuji, chanting Hare Krishna is very nice. We'll be benefited after quitting this body. In after quitting this body, we'll go to Golok Vrindavan and then we'll be with Krishna. But one thing is for sure, as long as we are in this material world, we need money. Of course, we need taste for a holy name, but we also need money. So my dear sir, do you think that Krishna is a mad fellow? He doesn't understand your feelings. He doesn't understand your needs. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu at Navadi Mayapur Dham, when he was in the mood of Mahavishnu, he was performing that Ashtaprahari Lila. He called Sridhar Kolabacha. Sridhar Kolabacha had absolutely nothing. He had no facilities. And Chaitanya Bhagavat explains that his shirt or a kurta, there were more holes than the cloth. So, absolutely he had nothing. In his house, the furniture and everything was one just small vessel, that lota for drinking water, and no other facility. So when during Ashtaprahari Lila, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu called Sridhar Kolabacha, he said, my dear Sridhar, ask anything, I'll give you. Sridhar looked at Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He said, Mahaprabhu, I don't want anything. Mahaprabhu said, Sridhar Kolabacha, did you understand my question properly? I am asking, ask any material benedictions. If you want, I can make you Indra. Chaitanya Bhagavat explains. If you want, I can make you Indra. My dear sir, we must understand what we are now chanting Hare Krishna mantra. If a person dies without completing his devotion 100%, that person, anyone who chants Hare Krishna mantra for many years and dies completing his 100% journey, next life, if someone has a material desires, every single person, at least one decade, if he chants Hare Krishna mantra, he is eligible to become a king of the planet. This is not false. This is the true. If someone chants Hare Krishna mantra for many, many years and suddenly leaves his body, that person becomes eligible to become the king of the planet. What is become small? Become a prime minister, a CM, or this puny things of this world. But you may say, Prabhu, but that is after quitting the body. What about the present life? And therefore, Krishna, he came in front of Dhruva Maharaj. And Dhruva Maharaj said, my dear Krishna, I don't want anything. I was searching for some broken pieces of glasses and now I got the diamond. Krishna said, no, I'll give you, I'll make you the king. I'll give all the material facilities. You know why? Because people will think that Krishna purifies your heart and he doesn't supply, doesn't give your material facilities. So you become king. Not only that, when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went to Srivas Angan and he said, my dear Srivas, I can see you have a joint family. In your family, there are at least 25 to 30 people staying. How do you manage your family? And Srivas clapped for three times. Mahaprabhu said, I didn't understand this three clapping philosophy. Then Srivas Thakur said, my dear sir, my dear Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, I have full faith that whatever my needs are, Krishna will fulfill. And if somehow or other Krishna doesn't fulfill my needs, I'll drown myself into Ganga and quit my body. Mahaprabhu said, really, you have so much faith in the holy name? One time, one person asked this question. This is my favorite story. One person asked this question to Swamiji. Swamiji, I don't believe in God. I don't believe in God because there are no proofs. Prabhupada said, you need a proof? Then Prabhupada said, since the time of creation till now, for millions and millions of years, not a single living entity, whether it's an animal, it's a bird, or a beast, or a reptile, or an insect, died without food. Just imagine, just to use this common sense and this logic. There are so many unlimited entities, insects, cockroaches, ants, and so many living entities, and elephants and big animals. Not even single entity died without food. And we need food every moment. Practically, so there are some animals like goats, they eat whole day. At least we eat human beings at least 3 times, right? Sometimes food, ambi bakri se chalte rehte, kuch chocolate aata hai, ye aata, chalte rehta hai. But at least 3 times we need that proper meal, isn't it? Who supplies them? If you want, if you have a scientific brain, try to understand this fact. Who supplies food to all these living entities? If an ant needs little quantity, Krishna supplies. Elephants wants and elephant needs tons of food, Krishna supplies. So, and why Krishna supplies to them? Because those, apart from human being, all other creatures, they have full faith in Krishna. They have full faith in the material nature. And therefore, Krishna supplies them. So, if we also have full faith, Krishna will not... Are Krishna gives to the rascals, even to atheists. Why will he not supply to his devotees? Of course, we have to, very practically, we have to work on and go to the job and this and that. But still, we should understand, Krishna is there. Parama karuna pahuduija nitai gora dekho ore bhai ki bhuvane na emono doyalata. Who can be more merciful than Sri Lord Shri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? The usual trend is, whenever any incarnation of Krishna appears, they simply kill. kill the demons, right? They kill the demons and establish the religious process, dharma. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he did not kill Jagai and Madai. He gave them Krishna prema. By saying this, Yamraj fainted. He said, it's unimaginable. Because those who chant Hare Krishna mantra regularly, it is mentioned that Chitragupta, he throws their file of their karma into the fire. In Chaitanya Bhagavad is mentioned, Chitragupta throws that file of karma, sinful reactions, into the fire. So, this Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, therefore Prabhupada, he's such an amazing acharya, unlimitedly merciful. First thing he did, wherever Prabhupada went, he established Gauranithai deities. He went to the African countries, he went to so many other countries, and he established Gauranithai because he knew that in this Kali Yuga, only Gauranithai can save everyone. So Prabhupada established Gauranithai. One time Prabhupada was sitting in his room at Sri Radha Rasbihari Temple, Juhu, and he was having a meeting with his devotees, and suddenly one construction worker, he entered the room. He had a flower bouquet in his hand. And he humbly came in front of Srila Prabhupada. And with full respect and gratitude, he offered pranam to Prabhupada and offered that flower at the lotus feet of Prabhupada. And without speaking anything, he just left. After seeing this gesture, there were tears in Prabhupada's eyes. You know what Prabhupada said after that? Prabhupada said, see, I am an ordinary person. Even I am moved by this humility of this person. Can you imagine? Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he is the ocean of mercy. If someone chants with humility, this point is very, very important. You know, what is the success of a devotee? Of course, becoming a famous and star and coming in the front of people, that is very nice. That is also one kind of seva. But to become humble like a lamb. Lamb means a small baby sheep. Baby sheep. When we see a lamb, baby sheep, do you feel fearful of it? Is anyone in this world feels fearful when they see a small lamb? Never. No one. Even if your small child, baby, walks and goes to the, close to that small baby sheep, you will feel also comfortable, no problem. It will not harm. Are you afraid of a lion? Are you afraid of a tiger? Yes. The roaring of a lion. Simply by roaring of a lion, we become so afraid. My dear sir, sometimes we make our personality such like, you know, walking like a lion, like a tiger, very royal. And we speak in a way that everyone is afraid of us. And we become, my God, see, everyone is afraid of me. I am such a great Vaishnava. Okay, for service sake, we may have that personality, but Krishna will not like it. We may chastise someone or correct someone as a seva, but that should not be our inner structure. That should not be our personality. So when we become like a lamb, that will melt the heart of a Vaishnava, that will melt the heart of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu, Chaitanya, Nityananda, they are so merciful. And Prabhupada, Acharyas, or the great personality, they are so merciful. Even though we are not qualified to receive the holy name, we are not qualified to accept Krishna prema, but these acharyas, they by their own power, by their own bhakti, they make us qualified to accept Krishna. Bhajagara parama karuna pahutuye ja nitai gora changa. Parama karuna pahutuye ja nitai gora changa.
Tai Gorachandra.
Do you want to know the power of holy name? Do you want to understand the power of holy name? All of you?
Yes.
Jai. Then study the life of Srila Prabhupada. It is not a formality always to speak about Prabhupada, but now just we'll all study together. Did you see any Shahenshah or a Mard or a Don? By their Don power, they transform the heart of people from all over the world. Here is an original spiritual Don, a Shahenshah or a Mard. What a personality! Within 12 years, he did not change their religion. He did not convert them. He transformed their heart. It is not you because you are a Muslim, now become Hindu. You are a Christian, now become Hindu. No, sir. If you are a Hindu, become Krishna conscious. If you are a Muslim, become Krishna conscious. If you are a Christian, become Krishna conscious. Transformation of the heart. You may not buy Shastra power for political power. You may convert people or you may do some changes in their heart. But Prabhupada, because he had full faith in Gaur Nitya's mercy and he had full faith in Hare Krishna mantra's power. Therefore, old man, 69, 70 years old, going to the garden without even speaking anything, now ringing his bell, that kartal, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Can you imagine such a faith? Because he had such a faith that simply by chanting Hare Krishna mantra, these people may not understand my language, they may not understand my accent, but simply by chanting Hare Krishna mantra, they will be purified. So Prabhupada is such an acharya. Therefore, Baul baul bolche sabe, hoche baul kon jana, baul baul bolche sabe, hoche baul kon jana. Baul baul bolte sabe hoche baul kon jana. Mukhe Hare Krishna bolo, Mukhe Hare Krishna bolo, Chador bhair kotha chalo. Naam bina tu susambala, chan baul deke, baul baul bolte sabe hoche baul kanjana. Baul baul bolte sabe hoche baul kanjana. Mukhe Hare Krishna bolu. Every day, Prabhupada said, chant Hare Krishna mantra. All of us have a brush, no? Every day morning we brush our teeth. What happens if you don't brush regularly? If you don't brush our teeth every day, what will happen? Huh? Bad breath, foul smell, right? The teeth also will become rusted and there will be bad breath, foul smell. So, therefore, brushing every day is so important. Similarly, if you don't chant every day, 16 rounds, there will be bad thoughts. Here is a bad breath, there is a bad thought. And again, we'll lose the taste for holy name, so many things will happen. Therefore, Prabhupada said, just like when you brush every day regularly, similarly, you chant 16 rounds every day. Now, please listen this one pastime very attentively. My humble request to all of you. One time, what is the name of devotee? Nandakumar Prabhu. Nandakumar Prabhu was a personal secretary of Srila Prabhupada. And he was chanting 16 rounds every day. One day, he completed his 14 rounds. And it was 10 o'clock in the night. He became very tired. So he completed 16 rounds. So he thought, anyway, I'm very tired. I'll chant these 2 rounds tomorrow. So he slept. He chanted 14 rounds and he slept. Next day morning, he went to Prabhupada's room. And Prabhupada, first question he asked him, so Nandakumarji, nowadays you are completing your 16 rounds? So Nandakumar was shocked. How does Prabhupada know this? Then, because he is a spiritual master, how can I lie to him? He said, sorry, Prabhupada, yesterday I was very tired. I could finish only 14 rounds, and 2 rounds are still remaining. Prabhupada looked at him, and very compassionately, Prabhupada said, my dear Nandakumar, when a devotee is chanting 16 rounds every day, that means a small child who is now learning to walk, and the child is holding the hands of his mother. When the child is learning to walk and holding the hands of his mother, the child is safe. As soon as the child gives up and no more holding the hands of his mother, the child will fall on the ground. Then Prabhupada said, chanting 16 rounds is exactly like that. When we are chanting every day 16 rounds, that means we are holding the hands of Krishna and we are safe. And when we give up regular chanting of 16 rounds, that means we are on our own. So how can we? Now we cannot stand, we cannot walk because we are a small child. So without the help of Krishna, how can we continue walking? So therefore, chanting 16 rounds, Prabhupada, is so important. Nitya Siddha Krishna Prem Sadhya Kabunai Shravanadi Shuddha Chutte Koroye Vodai. That Krishna Prem is there present in our heart in a dormant stage. But by Shravanadi Shuddha Chitte, by hearing every day, chanting Krishna's holy name every day, simply by hearing, that Krishna Prem will arise in our heart. One devotee asked Srila Prabhupada, Prabhupadji, what is the ideal chanting? Should we remember Krishna's pastime while chanting Hare Krishna mantra? Sometimes we also will know, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, then we remember Vrindavan and Radha and Krishna, and they're performing Rasa Leela, this, that. So he asked question to Prabhupada. So Prabhupada, do you recommend remembering Krishna's pastimes during chanting? Prabhupada said, Prabhupada writes a letter, in the letter it is mentioned, it is required to remember Krishna's pastimes while chanting, but it should come naturally. You should not make efforts to remember pastimes of Krishna. Sri Radhika Madhavayorapar Madhurja Leela Gunarupanamnam. By chanting Radha and Madhava's Hare Krishna mantra, Rupa, Leela, Guna, Dhyana, their pastime, their dham, everything will be revealed to you. But the first stage is simply hear. When we chant Hare Krishna mantra, there is mind should be focused on hearing the sound. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. That focus should be on hearing. And then when we become sufficiently purified, that holy name will reveal to us Radha, Krishna's, their qualities, their beauty, their forms, their spiritual abode, Golok Vrindavan. Everything will be revealed to us when we chant every day and hear attentively. Once there were baseball players in America, the best baseball player of America, and they were interviewed. My dear sir, when you play baseball in the ground, what is your focus? What do you remember? Because there are hundreds and thousands of people sitting in the stadium. What is your focus? And all the baseball players, they said, we simply focus on the ball. Where the ball is moving, where the ball is moving. We simply focus on the ball, and then simply by focusing on the ball, we become victorious. Simply Prabhupada said, just hear. Then Prabhupada word is used this word. Just hear, simply hear the holy name. Other things, you will be victorious. Bhaj Gaurango, kaho Gaurango, laho Gaurangira Namade. 5 minutes more, but.
Jana Gaurango, bhaje se har mur pran re.
So till now we discussed that chanting Hare Krishna mantra, even by Helanam, Stobham, Sankhyatam or Parihasyam, you will get the benefit. But if you want to please Krishna, then how we should chant? Just like a mother. Suppose mother has two children. One is 2 years of old and the other is 20 years old. Mother has two sons. One is 2 years old, other is 20 years old. Mother loves both the kids. She loves both the child. But one child is always dependent on mother. 2 years child always just wants to be in the arms of mother. Wants to sit on the shoulder of a mother. But that 20 years old boy, he is dependent on mother, but he also shares the responsibility of a mother. Both the children are dear to mother. But this older child, 20 years old child, he is, although inside heart dependent on the mother, but this child also shares the responsibility of a mother. Therefore, this child is superior. So similarly, we should chant, not just now, there is no question of one round, 2 rounds, 3 rounds, 4 rounds, minimum 16 rounds. If you want to be in the category of the 20 years old boy, chanting 16 rounds, following the 40 principles, and then sharing the responsibility of a mother. Mahaprabhu said, what is that? Amaragya guru hoya tara yai desh. It is our, agya means it's our request. So please, you become a devotee and make others devotees. That means now you are a grown-up child. You are 20 years child. So how the 20 years child will act? Just like we have a chanting Hare Krishna beads. What is a, not bad chanting, but compromise chanting, and what is ideal chanting? Compromise chanting means sometimes devotees, they are chanting, also driving. Sometimes people drive their cars, ek haath se gear badalte, and Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, wo bhi chal raha hai. See, we are not finding faults in the devotees. Even if you are chanting while driving, Krishna will accept. If you are 2 years child, mother will love you, no problem, don't worry. But do you want to remain on that only that 2 years old level, or you want to be a grown up child of 20 years? So driving, chanting along with driving. Aha, nowadays there are no newspapers, but there is a mobile. I'm extremely sorry. Sometimes it happens by me also. Mobile, left hand. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna. Facebook, WhatsApp, Instagram, YouTube. That like chanti becomes so easy, right? 2 hours kab chala gaya pata bhi nahi chala. How my 16 rounds are completed, I don't even realize, you know. And then finally, after the 16 rounds, I see my 16 rounds are completed. Wow, today's quota complete. But my dear sir, your mind was fully into only Facebook, Instagram, and WhatsApp and YouTube. So, actually this is not good, this compromise, because actually we are 24 hours are meant only for this 2 hours chanting. Hum log ulta karte hai usko. We said, 2 hours, so much of time, you know, I should utilize this time. Simply by chanting. So we can, when I'm traveling, I'm not, anyway, I'm traveling in Mumbai for 2 hours, traffic jam mein, mala bhi ho jayegi. I can chant my round, 16 rounds in 2 hours. Dono time bach jayega. Traffic mein bhi time bach jayega, ye bhi hoga. So, sometimes Mataji is, while cooking, chanting, cleaning, chanting, shopping, chanting, prajalpa chanting. I am not an ideal person. I am also included in this compromise chanting. But we all have to increase our quality of our chanting. And sometimes we have that clicker, click. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Or is that before even you finish that one round, click, 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 4 times, 5 times, who bhi gaya idhar. We use that. Sometimes people say, no, I go to companies, you know. So I cannot chant on my beads. Therefore, I carry this. What do you call it? Counter, counter. So here is left hand counter, right hand. Right hand is left hand. Right hand. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. With the speed of Hare Krishna, either click, 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 click. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. So this will be like a Birbal ki khichdi. Birbal ki khichdi means that pot hanging to the ceiling and fire is on the bottom. So how much time it will take for the cooking of the khichdi? We don't know when we'll cook. So, therefore, of course, we are all sadhakas, but we must take at least the chanting process seriously. If we take chanting Harinam Sankirtan seriously, all the things will fall in the right places. If you chant Hare Krishna mantra for regularly, nicely, attentively, what do you want? Tell me. You want money? Krishna will supply you money. You want resources, facilities. Kya chahiye life mein tumko? Are, for Krishna, it's not at all difficult to provide you some material facilities. We should have full faith. Baj gaurango, kaho gaurango, laho gaurange ranam, jana gaurango, baj te hai mur prana.
Questions? Prabhu, questions?
Ah, okay.
Hare Krishna. Prabhuji, my question is, can I go back to Godhead without taking initiation?
Yes.
No, but completely chanting like Prabhupada, chanting Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, and following all the principles completely, like, you know, without even not getting married. I'm not getting to marry because I want to chant 6 months completely. Please tell me, can I go to back to Godhead and film Krishna's love in my heart without taking initiation?
I understood your question. Give me mic. Whoever chants 16 rounds, follow the four regular principles, they will go back to Godhead. And initiation means that person has to have some connection with the sampradaya and the parampara. And marriage is not compulsory, but it is needed. You know why? As a single person, either in this ashram, or a grahastha ashram, or a brahmacharya ashram, or a sannyasi ashram, if that person is hanging in between, we cannot give guarantee of our mind when the mind will cheat to us. Therefore, sadhana bhakti is very, very important. And sadhana bhakti, the ashram also is one of the part, aspect of sadhana bhakti. So if you want to chant 16 rounds throughout your life, that person has to be stabled, settled in his life. And settled means either of this ashram or that ashram, not in between. So if you want to chant 16 rounds Hare Krishna mantra every day, so please continue and you will surely go back to God if you continue and nicely chant 16 rounds. Jai. Srila Prabhupada ki Jai.
Please be seated. So let us thank Shivram Prabhuji for wonderful giving us guidance. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare. The glories of Holy Name. Thank you, Prabhuji. Wonderfully. Kirtan, just the first time jo aaye unke hum. So, aaj jo first time aaye itna sundar program ke liye, unka hum vishesh roop se swagat karna chahte hain. Jo bhi first time is